Morning Glory America. It's Hugh Hewitt. Evening Grace, if you're listening on tape delay or on our podcast. But Nancy Pelosi talked yesterday. Here's what she said in her presser. Cut number 16 is where she announces what she's doing.
Our Republican doors, because of the wisdom of our Constitution, enshrined in three co-equal branches of government, serving as checks and balances on each other. The actions taken to date by the president have seriously violated the Constitution, especially when the president says, Article 2 says I can do whatever I want. For the past several months, we have been investigating in our committees and litigating in the courts so the House can gather all the relevant facts and consider whether to exercise its full Article 1 powers, including a constitutional power of the utmost gravity, approval of articles of impeachment. And this week, the president has admitted to asking the president of Ukraine to take actions which would benefit him politically. The actions of the Trump presidency revealed the dishonorable fact of the president's betrayal of his oath of office, betrayal of our national security, and betrayal of the integrity of our elections. Therefore, today, I'm announcing the House of Representatives moving forward with an official impeachment inquiry. I'm directing our six committees to proceed with their investigations under that umbrella of impeachment inquiry. The president must be held accountable. No one is above the law.
The umbrella of impeachment inquiry doesn't tell us anything. It means the six committees are still doing their clown shows. Adam Schiff, Jerry Nadler, I think Elijah Cummings has one of them. They have six different clown shows going on, and they got to bring them all together under, but they need to vote a select committee, and they've got to pick a select committee, and that's going to make people mad. So Nancy's just buying time. She went on to say at length that Donald Trump is violating law by withholding the whistleblower complaint. Cut number 17.
Last Tuesday, we observed the anniversary of the adoption of the Constitution on September 17th. Sadly, on that day, the intelligence community inspector general formally notified the Congress that the administration was forbidding him from turning over a whistleblower complaint on Constitution Day. This is a violation of law. Shortly thereafter, press reports began to break of a phone call by the President of the United States calling upon a foreign power to intervene in his election. This is a breach of his constitutional responsibilities. The facts are these. The intelligence community inspector general, who was appointed by President Trump, determined that the complaint is both of urgent concern and credible. And its disclosure, he went on to say, relates to one of the most significant and important of the Director of National Intelligence's responsibility to the American people. On Thursday, the Inspector General testified before the House Intelligence Committee, stating that the acting Director of National Intelligence blocked him from disclosing the whistleblower complaint. This is a violation of law. The law is unequivocal. The DNI staff, it says the DNI Director of National Intelligence shall provide Congress the full whistleblower complaint. For more than 25 years, I've served on the Intelligence Committee as a member, as the ranking member, as part of the Gang of Four, even before I was in the leadership. I was there when we created the Office of the Director of National Intelligence. That did not exist before 2004. I was there even earlier in the 90s when we wrote the whistleblower laws and continue to write them to improve them to ensure the security of our intelligence and the safety of our whistleblowers. I know what their purpose was, and we proceeded with balance and caution as we wrote the laws. I can say with authority the Trump administration's actions undermine both our national security and our intelligence and our protections of the whistleblowers, more than both. This Thursday, the acting DNI will appear before the House Intelligence Committee. At that time, he must turn over the whistleblower's full complaint to the committee.
He's not going to do that because constitutionally the law doesn't apply to the president. You ought to know that Speaker Pelosi was shot down, according to Paul Sperry, by her caucus in her bid to form one impeachment committee, similar to the Hyde Committee or the Rodino Committee. And she capitulated no fewer than six committee chairs to jointly lead the investigation. That includes Waters, Maxine Waters, and Elijah Cummings, and Adam Schiff, and Jerry Nadler. So they don't actually have a select committee. They actually don't have anything. Susan Ferriccio of the Washington Examiner asked Rules Committee Chairman Jim McGovern if there's a plan to have the House vote to open a formal impeachment inquiry, to which he responded, "Not that I know of." They are really a Keystone Cops gang in the House Democrats. They don't know what they're doing. Studio joined now by Congressman Mike Gallagher. Follow him at Rep. Gallagher on Twitter. Congressman, do you speak any foreign languages?
I speak Arabic.
You speak Arabic. Now, if you were on a board of a country, a company that had a foreign language that was outside of Arabic, do you think you'd be worth $50,000 a month if you didn't speak the language of the country in which the company operated?
I do not think I'd be worth $50,000 a month.
Hey, let me get to the important stuff. Nancy Pelosi announced nothing yesterday. She had a press conference and she announced nothing. As far as I can translate it, nothing changed. Am I right, Mike Gallagher?
100%. The proper procedure would be to vote to authorize an official inquiry, which Republicans did in 1998 relative to Bill Clinton. But Pelosi has not done this, and I fear she doesn't intend to. So this inquiry starts in the worst and least transparent way possible. Instead, this afternoon, we are going to be voting on a resolution to prematurely release the August 12th whistleblower complaint, even though we are already getting the report by the end of the week. House Democrats, in my opinion, having already voted on impeachment twice before the Mueller report was even done, are trying to force a vote on a resolution that is based purely on unverified claims of wrongdoing on part of the administration. The resolution even quotes Washington Post articles, and we simply don't know anything about the veracity of the whistleblower's claims. The president has said he's going to release the transcript of the call and the IG report on the whistleblower. So I fundamentally do not understand what this vote this afternoon is about. And to your original point, Hugh, I have heard nothing that suggests they're going to do a formal vote on an impeachment inquiry. And that's largely because I don't think she wants to put her vulnerable members, many of whom are in Trump districts, in that position right now.
Yeah, and so at the end of after you vote for this, what changes that was different from what was going on yesterday?
Nothing other than the speaker has directed six committee chairs, to include Maxine Waters and Jerry Nadler and Adam Schiff, to compile all of their complaints against the Trump administration into one big document that presumably would form articles of impeachment, and they would fast forward directly to that part in the process. But let's talk about this. Let's say you have a listener who just doesn't know what's going on, right? Doesn't know if Trump did something wrong or doesn't really know. The problem is if you start off on this sort of process foul point, you're going to completely destroy what little credibility you have right now. I mean, impeachment, to my knowledge, has only been used three times in our country's history. You're talking about overturning the results of an election when we have a little over a year before another election. So you're talking about overturning the will of the American people. This is a dramatic step. You have to be willing to do it in the most open, honest, and transparent way possible. And I fear they are starting off from a completely non-transparent and muddled process, and that is not going to redound to Pelosi's benefit.
Do you have any idea how Joe Biden's son, Hunter Biden, could qualify for $50,000 a month?
Well, it's an example of foreign influence peddling that I think is out of control in the swamp. I mean, he has absolutely no expertise in the energy sector, and so the only reason is that his dad was the vice president. There's even more alarming questions about his work in China. He reportedly went with his father on Air Force Two for a trip that resulted in a Beijing-linked company's making a $1.5 billion deal with Hunter's investment firm. That is the swamp at its worst. That's political dynasty.
Repeat that for me.
reportedly, he went with his father on Air Force Two for a trip to China that resulted in Chinese companies making a $1.5 billion deal with Hunter's investment firm. I mean, I, to my knowledge, he doesn't have any China expertise either.
More to come on that. Let's we'll keep talking.